So we'll continue the three-dimensional geometry. Today we'll discuss about parallel and perpendicular lines. Look at here. Parallel and perpendicular lines. Okay, see, suppose there are two lines AB and CD. That's it. Let BR of AB line as A1, A2, A3. BR of CD line. Sorry, this is A1, B1, C1. This is A2, B2, C2. Okay. Agar AB is parallel to CD, then formula will be A1 by A2 equals to B1 by B2 equals to C1 by C2. Remember, parallel formula. And AB perpendicular to CD. CD, this is AB, suppose, perpendicular. Then AB perpendicular to CD, A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2 equals to 0. These two you remember. Okay, so go to your exercise. Simple questions will be doing based on this. We are given here so that exercise 11.2. Question number 1. So that the lines with direction cosines (12/13) -3/13) -4/13), again 4/13), 12/13), and 3/13). Okay, and -3/13), -4/13), 12/13), are mutually perpendicular lines. Are mutually perpendicular. Look at here the direction cosines are given. You can see here three lines. Suppose this is O, this is A, this is B, this is C. Okay, it's suppose this is L1, M1, N1 as the BC. This is L2, M2, N2 as BC. N3 as BC. Three direction cosines I have taken here. So now you can look at here. Actually, that time I could not tell you. Now you remember, if there is a line AB, this is CD. If they are perpendicular, it is L1, L2, L3. This is L1, M1, M1. This is L2, M2, M2. Perpendicular means the formula is written L1, L2 plus M1, M2. M1, M2 equals to 0. In terms of direction, cosines, this is the formula. In terms of direction ratios, that will be A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is 0. So this value is given how much? Look at it. So, I can draw here. This line, if I copy here, this is 12 by 13 minus 3 by 13 minus 4 by 13. This line, 4 by 13, 12 by 13, 3 by 13. Okay, this line, 3 by 13 minus 4 by 13 and 12 by 13. Okay, so you can write OA perpendicular to OB implies L1, L2, M1, M2, L1, M2 equals to 0. So what is L1, M1, N1? I have taken here L2, M2, N2. That means 12 by 13. You can write 12 by 13 into 4 by 13 minus 3 by 13 into 12 by 13 plus minus 4 by 13 into 3 by 13. Let's say this is 0 or not. 13, 13 is LCM. 48 minus 36 minus 12. So 0 by 169, that is 0. Proved. Similarly, OB perpendicular OC. If these two are perpendicular, same formula. So what will write? L2, L3, L2, L3, L2, L3 should be 0. So find out 4 by 13 into 3 by 13. Twelve by 13 into minus 4 by 13. 3 by 13 into minus 4 by 13. You are getting. Same thing. 169 is the LCM. 12 minus 48 this is 3 and 12 4, 3 12, 4 3 3, 12 3, 12 plus 36. So 0 by 169, that is 0. Again you can say OA perpendicular to OC. So OA perpendicular OC implies L, this is L1 M3 plus M1 M3, L1 M3 equals to 0. So you can verify 12 into 3 by 12 by 13 into 3 by 13 minus 3 by 13 into minus 4 by 13 then minus 4 by 13 into 12 by 13. So how much you got? 169 This is 36 minus 48, sorry, plus 12. Plus 12 minus 48. That is also 0/169, that is 0. So in terms of direction cosines, we will use this formula. See the next question, that will clear you about the direction ratios. Go to question number 2. So question number 2. So that the lines through, through the points one minus one, two, and three minus four, two. Three, four minus two is perpendicular to the line through the points 0, 3, 2 8, 3, 5, 6. Okay. So what will you find? Line through this. Suppose A and B. Its coordinates are 1, -1, 2. This is 3, 4, -2. Perpendicular to the line C and D. C is what? 0, 3, 2. D is what? 3, 5, 6. Okay. When 2 points are given, what you can find out? You can find the direction ratios first. So let's find out what is DR of AB line. DR of AB line, that is A1, B1, C1. How to find? When points are given, terminal minus initial, yesterday we discussed, 3 minus 1 is 2, 4 plus 1 is 2, minus 2 minus 2. That means this is 2 is to 5 is to minus 4. DR of AB, let's find what is DR of CD. DR of CD line, that is A2, B2, C2. How to find? CD terminal minus initial, 3 minus 0, 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2. So that is 3, 2, 4. Okay. Then two lines are perpendicular. What formula I gave you? That AB perpendicular to CD. AB perpendicular to CD if A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 equals to 0. This is the formula. So A1, A2, 2 and 3. 2 into 3 plus 5 into 2 plus minus 4 into 4. Let's say whether it is 0 or not. It's coming 0. That is 6 plus 10 minus 16, which is 0. Therefore, AB is perpendicular to CD. Okay.
Then next one is a question number parallel given here.
Question number 3. So that they are parallel. Same method. So that the lines line through the point points 4, 7, 8 2, 3, 4 is parallel to the line through the points 1, 1, 2, 5.
Concept is same. Points are given means
here this is AB line, this is CD line. Okay. What is given? 4, 7, 8. 4, 7, 8. B 2, 3, 4. This is -1. C connect. This is C. This is D. C is what? -1. -2, 1. This is 1, 2, 5.
1, 2, 5. Okay. Let's find what is DR of AB line.
DR of AB line. A1, B1, C1. How much?
AB. You can write 2 minus 4.
2 minus 4. 3 minus 7. 4 minus 8. How much you got? This is -2, -4, -4.
Okay, you can simplify it. How can you simplify? Divide by -2 because ratio form.
So it will be 1:2, 2:2.
DR of AB line, let's find what is DR of CD line.
DR of CD line, that is A2, B2, C2.
Ratio, so that is writing in the ratio form. So that will give you how much? CD 1 minus minus plus.
1 plus 1, 2 plus 2, 5 minus 1. That is 2:4:4.
If you want to divide, you can divide also
2. That will be 1:2:2.
So you can show AB parallel to CD.
AB parallel to CD if A1 by A2 equals to B1 by B2 equals to C1 by C2.
Okay, take it. What did you get earlier?
It is 1 by 1. That is also 2 by 2. That is 2 by 2.
So same ratio, not? 1 by 1 is 1, 2 by 2 is 1, 2 by 2 is 1.
So proof. Therefore, AB is parallel to CD
because the ratio is same. Okay? Now we'll discuss the straight line in the space. Straight line in the space. So you can write line is determined in the space two conditions. What are the conditions? Passing through a point and is parallel to a given vector. That means you can determine a line in the space if it is passing through a point and parallel to a given vector. That we will discuss. Second point is passing through two given points. Also, you can determine line if it is passing through two points. So let's discuss this one first. What is the equation of a line passing through a point and parallel to a given vector? See here. Find the equation of a line passing through a given point that is x1, y1, z1. Passing through a given point and is parallel to given vector B, that is B1i, B vector, that is B1i, B2j, B3k. See here. Suppose this is a three dimensional figure, the space you are taking. This is a line. A is the point whose coordinate is x1, y1, z1. Achha. Passing through a given point. Suppose this is P. Any point whose coordinate is x, y, z. A I can write here x1, y1, z1. So, equation of AP you want to find out. When this point is given, means values of xy, x1, y1, z1 is given parallel to the given vector B. This is parallel. Got the point? Okay. How to find? This is given, this is given. You are asked to find equation of AP line. So what you can do here is, let's join this. This is suppose A vector. This is suppose your R vector. Okay. So let OA vector equals to, when point with reference to origin, you can write in the IJK form, that is x1i y1j plus z1k.
P of XYZ be any point on the line. Can any arbitrary point P on the line. So what will be OP then? OP vector will be R vector. So this is your A vector. OA equals to A vector, which is X1I plus Y1Z plus Z1. Okay, this is your R vector. What is that? XI plus YJ plus ZK. Vector law of addition, OA plus AP equals to OP. OA plus AP equals to OP. That is vector law of addition. So what is then AP law? AP will be equal to OP minus OA. So what is OP then? This is R vector minus A vector. That is R vector minus A vector. AP is parallel to B vector. So what do you get here? AP is parallel to B vector. I told you earlier that if two vectors are parallel, in the vector chapter I told you, if two vectors are parallel, one can be written as some scalar multiple of other vector. This concept always you keep in the mind. Means they differ by the magnitude only. That magnitude is lambda here. Their unit vector will be same. So I can write here, AP equals to lambda times B. I can write because one is scalar multiple of other vector. But what is AP line? AP is R minus A. So R minus A vector equals to lambda B vector. Got the point? Now, so now R, you can R minus A equals to lambda B. Okay, if R minus A equals to lambda B implies R equals to A plus lambda B. That means what R is determining here? You are determining here, if the point A is given, this is your point A. A vector means with reference to the given point and a parallel vector. So always when you find an equation in this form, you have to understand this is your point, this is your parallel vector. So this is called vector form. Vector form. Okay? Then let's see the Cartesian form. Cartesian form. So Cartesian form means like R vector equals to A plus lambda B implies XI plus YJ plus ZK equals to X1I Y1J plus Z1K. Let me write here. X1I Y1J plus Z1K plus lambda times B1I B2J B3K.
Okay, let's simplify this part. What will you get?
Implies X1I, Y1J, Z1K equals to.
You can take here I common
X1 plus lambda B1, J common X2 plus lambda B2, plus K common X3 plus lambda B3.
Now if you compare both, so this is XI, XI, YJ, ZK. Now compare I to I, X equals to X1 plus lambda B1. So comparison gives you X is X1 plus lambda B1. Okay, then this gives you, if I subtract here X minus X1, then B1 will come down equals to lambda. Similarly, Y equals to Y equals to Y1 plus lambda B2.
Y equals to Y1 plus lambda B2.
This implies Y minus Y1, Y minus Y1 by B2 equals to lambda.
Z equals to Z1 plus lambda B3 imply Z minus Z1 by B3 equals to lambda.
These three ratios are equal here. So Cartesian form will be
Cartesian form of the line X minus X1 by B1, Y minus Y1 by B2, Z minus Z1 by B3.
This is Cartesian form. Okay, once more I want to remind you, suppose there is a line here, this is the point A, coordinate is x1, y1, z1, parallel vector is B, that is B1i, B2j, B3k. Look at the pattern here, x1, y1, z1 is your given point. B1, B2, B3 are direction ratios of this line. So if you are asked to find direction ratio of the parallel vector, then you have to find out this one. If you are asked to find equation of the line passing through the point, point means x1, y1, z1. So what else again you have to notice here? It is in the minus form. Second thing, x, y, z coefficient is 1. Then only it is the standard form of the line. Let me take one question. The question is,
find the vector in Cartesian form of the line passing through the point one, two, three in parallel to the vector 3i minus j cross 2k.
Okay, so see here,
all vector, this point is given. Point means your x1, y1, z1 is given, that is 1, 2, 3. You can convert this to a vector because point gives you a vector.
Look at the previous diagram I have drawn here.
That is I plus 2j plus 3k. Means if the point is given, you can convert to a vector like this. B vector is given, this is parallel vector. Parallel vector means which one? Look at the situation here. This is your point A. That is 1, 2, 3.
Okay?
That means x1, y1, z1. Parallel vector is B here. That is 3i. B vector one, two, three. B vector is this one. That is 3i minus j plus 2k. This is in this form.
Okay. So this is x1, y1, z1. This will be b1, b2, b3. So what is b1, b2, b3?
B vector is 3i minus j plus 2k. So what will be your b1, b2, b3? 3 minus 1, 2.
Okay. Then what is
vector form of line? Vector form of line r equals to a plus lambda b. A means I plus 2j plus 3k plus lambda times 3i minus j plus 2k. Vector form is done. You have write only in this, nothing more. Okay, Cartesian form. Cartesian form will be x minus x1 by b1, y minus y1 by b2, z minus z1 by b3.
Okay. So, what is the point you have got? X1, Y1, Z1,
X minus 1 by B1.
B1 means what? 3.
Y minus 2. B2 is minus 1. Z minus 3. B3 is 2. This is our Cartesian curve.
Okay, so more questions we'll discuss tomorrow.